just a little downhill. A little forward press. Sends this to the cup, and it misses on the right edge. So, like yesterday, Murray came here yesterday. He was 2 under. Hit his ball in the trees right, and then actually made a par here. And then made bogey at 8 and 9. That's a bogey, so back to 14 under at 7.
Well, the players who were chasing from far back, they don't mind it, but Dustin Johnson's very disappointed there. Looks like he just didn't keep the speed up on that short putt, and he hates to get one back.
Disappointing there, 3-putt bogey for DJ, Bill.
Yeah, now John Rahm waiting patiently here, and now this 3.5-footer doesn't look nearly as tough as DJ's putt, since Rahm had putted first, but if this goes in, he will share the lead once again. Just hasn't been able to have a lot of close looks for birdie. The one time he had it, he made it. Steadies the feet. 3.5-footer for par here at 7 for John Rahm. Runs this up to the cup and in. All right, that's a good 2-putt. So he's 14 under. So is Dustin Johnson. Co-leaders as they go to 8.
Yeah, which means up ahead at 8, Justin Thomas, a chance to get within one of the lead now. Again, Doug Bell.
Justin Thomas eyeing another birdie try. This one 24 feet away here at the 8th. It'll come off that ridge and should move from his left to right. The stroke sends it down the line, making the turn towards the hole, tracking to the cup, and it just went over the left side. That's a good-looking putt. He's had a lot of those, and he will walk up and finish up a 2-putt par. So Justin Thomas, clean card, 1 birdie at the 6th, and he stays at 12 under.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to make an occasional bogey, but pars are good at East Lake. Pars are good.
Well, Rory McIlroy, certainly par would be good for him now here at Kearney.
Definitely needs one again. Missed one from just longer than this, from 10 feet back at 8. I should 7. This one from 9.5 feet is on its way down the slope up to the cup and does not drop. Just slid by. So McIlroy, back-to-back bogeys for the first time this week. He only made 2 bogeys in the opening round, both on the front 9, but he made a bogey here yesterday, so he will drop a shot now as he taps in for his bogey here at 8, and he will drop back to 8 under.
Yeah, he was putting right to left with the front of the green to his right. I think he thought it would break to the right. He's looking at it as he walks off, not in anger, more in puzzlement. I think it was a misread.
Well, Dustin Johnson's putter betrayed him. Back at 7, 3-putt bogey, so we are tied up again. Dustin Johnson and John Rahm midway through a Saturday. DJ and Rahm, 14 under, heading to the 8th hole as PGA Tour radio coverage of Round 2 continues. PGA Tour's ultimate prize on the line this week, the FedEx Cup at the Tour Championship.
At CDW, we get putting.
At number 9, the par 3s, Andrew Schauffele put his tee shot in the bunker. Threw it up there about 6.5 feet below the cup. Now putting through the shadows for a second straight up and down. The stroke sends it at the hole dead center and drops to the bottom. Xander Schauffele with a couple of nice bunker shots and putts, and he stays at 9 under, bogey free. That's a 3 under 32 on his outward 9. So he heads to the second 9 with some momentum.
Former Tour champion there, playing well again this week. Xander Schauffele started the week -6, 4 shots back. Right now he's 9 under, which is 5 behind with John Rahm. Dustin Johnson tied for the lead again at 14 under. Back to you, Doug Bell.
All right, Earl. Keep in mind, this is only the second round. I know it's Saturday, but we still got a lot of golf to play, and I can't wait. This is going to be a blast leading up to Labor Day. Justin Thomas on the tee at the par 3 ninth, 243 yards away, uphill tee shot.
Former Tour champion Xander Schauffele doing what he does. I mean, he's been in the mix really every appearance he's made at this Tour Championship, and he's right there again now, up into a tie for 4th. Bill?
Well, here at the 8th, John Rahm, another fairway. He's only missed one here on this front 9. Let's see if he can get this close. He's got 147 yards to a testy little front right hole location. Dustin Johnson's tee shot a yard closer, but he's in one of those right fairway bunkers. Both players tied for the lead as Rahm plays away his second here at 8. Of course, water on the left, but the flag is right edge today, and that's safely in the middle of the green. And that'll be a testy little downhill putt there for John Rahm. Another long one. That proximity has not been good today with all the fairways, he said.
Yeah, that front right hole location is hard on eight, but I think players want to favor where John Rahm hit it. If you were to miss this green to the right, you're pitching right downhill, down green, no green to work with. Not much of a chance to get it close, Bill.
All right, here's DJ, a yard closer, but he's in one of the right fairway bunkers. The lie's fine. Lip shouldn't be a problem. Contact made. Again, the hole is located front right. And that comes up short of the green. That's in that closely mown area. Maybe 6-7 paces from the front edge. That'll be an uphill chip shot. So Dustin Johnson does not want to give another shot away. He's 14 under along with John Rahm as they walk up to green number 8.
Yeah, that's a little bit like the pitch he had just two holes ago on 6 when he did get it up and down. Pitch right up the hill. It's a good place to leave it if you're not going to put it on the green.
And this is the toughest hole in the front nine. I mean, the 8th hole, you know, and it's a different look this year. Unfortunately, no fans for the Tour Championship. So usually you have the grandstands and the chalets up that right-hand side where the players will air with the water on the left. Not so this year, Doug Bell.
Yeah, well, it's a strange look. It really is. It's a gorgeous golf course, but the grandstands just give it that feel of excitement, and the crowd's always really into it. Justin Thomas on the upslope right in front of this green. He's 78 feet away and has an awkward stance. And let's see if he can get this close. Looks like he has a club a little less loft. He's going to run it up, and here it comes. Running it across the green from the sunshine now into the shadows and rolls up about 4.5, maybe 5 feet from the cup. So again, work to do for Justin Thomas to stay bogey-free and 12 under here at 9.
Yeah, again, number 9 is that difficult uphill lengthy par 3. A 3 is a good score here. Justin Thomas hasn't really had a hot putter yet today, and he needs to have a little bit of a he needs to make one here, you know, not to lose any momentum as he's trying to catch Dustin Johnson and John Rahm heading into the back nine. If you wonder, what are they going to be facing in the back nine? Is it gettable? Well, Patrick Reed, who made 9 straight pars, birdied 10, now he's birdied 13, 15, and 16. So he's 4 under par, and all of those coming on the back nine, Earl, it is doable.
Yeah, the back nine's playing about half a shot easier than the front nine today, and the scoring's good again. It's more than a shot under par, 68.87. Mark Carnevale.
Yeah, lengthy birdie putt here at the 9th for Rory McIlroy, Earl. 41 feet. He's got a putt all along the back side of this green here. And the back of the green slopes from his right to left. About half of this putt is in sunlight, and then it goes into the shadow. This putt will definitely move right to left the whole way as McIlroy makes contact. He hasn't hit this one. Now ball coming up short and turning left. Continuing to trickle out a little bit. And that one ball actually trickles out right onto the edge of the shadow, and that's going to be, looks to me, a good 5 or 6 feet for McIlroy. So an aggressive putt. He's got it back coming up the hill, but he's got work left for another par.
Back to that 8th hole now, the tough par 4, Bill.
Third shot for Dustin Johnson here at the 8th. Just short of the green, 43 feet in all to a front right hole location. Plays this pitch on the putting surface, rolls to the flag, hits the flag, and drops in the cup. Oh, my goodness. Dustin Johnson. That's a birdie chip in here at 8, and he is back to 15 under par.
That is where good players miss in the right spot. It wasn't that difficult. I'm not saying it's easy to chip it in, but he played the perfect shot. That chip, as we watched it roll toward the hole, is never going to get away from him. Hits the flagstick dead center. What a great bounce-back birdie after the three-putt on the previous hole.
Wow, what a pickup, too, at the toughest hole in the front nine. Mark Carnevale, back to you.
Rory McIlroy rolls it in from about 5.5 feet here at the ninth to avoid 3 bogeys in a row. He'll make the turn at 1 over and head to the back nine at 8 under with a par here at 9.
That's another big par putt after missing par putts on both 7 and 8. Don't want to finish with 3 in a row. Remember, Rory, played a very good back nine yesterday. He's going to need another one today.
Well, Dustin Johnson today, couple of early birdies, moved in front at 3 with the birdie. John Rahm caught him, then DJ back in front with the birdie at 6. Dropped one to drop back and a share at 7. Now he's back in front again at 15 under, Doug Bell.
At number 9, Justin Thomas, 5.5 feet, big right to left bender for par save. The stroke sends it on the way, making the turn, but not enough. It burnt the right edge, but would not turn to the left anymore, so that's the first bogey of the day for Justin Thomas, and he's back where he started the day at 11 under.
Let's go back to Bill at the 8th.
John Rahm ready to go here. His birdie putt at 8. This is 31 feet. Got a front right hole location. He's hole high left, but in the middle of the green, so he's going to have to come down a slope. So this should be a pretty quick putt. Starts this out to the left. Starting to turn right. Got a stretch. He stands up and trying to edge it on to get in the cup. And all that talking to the golf ball did not work. So John's hit so many greens today. But other than that 4.5-footer, his closest birdie try has been 23 feet. That was from 31. He's going to finish up here. Just outside, well, inside 2 feet, we'll call it. Putter blade back through and in. That's a 4 for John Rahm, but he remains 14 under, DJ to 15.
Yeah, sometimes the difference is just a matter of holding putts, and the closer you hit it to the hole, the better chance you have. Both those players made mention of that. Dustin Johnson specifically said in the post-round interview, I've got to get it closer. I've got to hit fairways and get it closer to give myself some chances. And he's missed some fairways, but he has had a little bit of magic. Made 2 bombs in a row in his 3rd and 4th holes of the day. And made that great chip in right there on number 8.
Boy, that's just a huge pickup. And from, you know, missing the fairway and in the fairway bunker, you know, it's going to be tough to get there. Left himself short of the green and to knock it in, you know. So he's made a couple of bombs today, one of those birdies and a huge par saver right after that. And now back in front, DJ 15 under, one up on John Rahm, Bill.
Well, that's getting back at that 8th hole where he made bogey yesterday. Let's see what he does at 9, the par 3. 5-iron, airborne, and this is short in the bunker. This hole playing 243 yards today with a back left hole location. So DJ is going to have to make an up and down out of the sand. Yesterday he was 0 for 2 in that regard.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of players have to make up and downs on this hole. We've seen, you know, I don't know what the stats are. Earl, you're the stat guru. I mean, how many guys have hit that green in regulation? Is it even half the field so far today?
Well, today, yeah, it's exactly half with this final group playing in. 14 out of 28, 50%. And I was looking at that bunker, that front left bunker. Now, DJ's in the front end of it. So, that, I mean, that's going to be at least a 25-yard up and down there back hole location. It's 1 for 2 for players in the bunker, and then just short of the green, not in the bunker, Justin Thomas couldn't get up and down from outside 75 feet. So it's not going to be an easy one for DJ coming off the hole-out birdie to get up and down to stay 15 under, Bill.
And John Rahm has selected 4-iron here at 9. The par 3 playing 243 yards. Whatever breeze we have, and it's not much right now, it's in the face of the golfer. John makes contact. Back left hole location, leaning a little to his left. And that is short as well. That didn't get there. Not sure if it's caught the bunker or not, but neither player able to get it on the putting surface here at the 9th. We'll see if they can put their 3 on the card and make the turn.
Yeah, it's not in the bunker, Bill. It's short of the green, but it got even got my attention as strong as these guys are. 243 uphill into whatever little breeze there were. I'm not surprised a 4-iron came up short.
Long, tough par 3. It always is at 9th. Doug Bell, up to you.
Earl here at 10. Xander Schauffele, another up and down. This one from 7 feet. Remember now, he was up and down out of the bunker at 8 and 9, so he's done it again as Xander Schauffele remains bogey-free and 9 under par.
And a change atop the leaderboard. What's been a decent front 9 on a Saturday for Dustin Johnson just moved back in front.
Just short of the green, 43 feet in all to a front right hole location. Plays this pitch on the putting surface, rolls to the flag, rolls to the, hits the flag, and drops in the cup. Oh, my goodness. Dustin Johnson. That's a birdie chip in here at 8, and he is back to 15 under par.
And back in front, DJ by 1 on a Saturday as we continue coverage of the Tour Championship Eastlake Golf Club in Atlanta on PGA Tour Radio. Club established 1904, the oldest golf course in the city of Atlanta and the longtime home for the season finale on the PGA Tour, round 2 on a Saturday. This is coverage of the Tour Championship. Earl Forsey and former Tour champ Mark McCumber, our analyst this week, down to the golf course again. And we send you out to a longtime voice of college football on ESPN Radio, Bill Brzezinski.
And John Rahm has walked up to the green. We're at the 9th. the par three. Rahm's ball came up short of the green. He has pulled out the putter here. He's got 31 yards to this back left hole location. Dustin Johnson is in the bunker off to the left, but Rahm will play first. It's just been one of these strange rounds where he hasn't made many mistakes, but can't get any really good looks except for one hole for birdie. Yesterday, scrambling, John Rahm was 3 of 4. Let's see if he can make an up and down here at the ninth. Left leg a little higher than the right as he brings the putter blade back, and golf ball is moving. Boy, this has a lot of pace on it. That better hit the flag. No, it's going to run by. Stay on the green. And that went all the way to the collar and stayed up top, but that's going to be outside 10 feet, and that'll be for par for John Rahm.
Boy, it's easy to be second-guessing, I know, as a player. You can't really do that. You've got to go with your gut. But I thought that ball could easily hop through that much fringe, but it came over so smooth that he's blown that through the green, Bill.
All right, here's DJ out of the bunker on the left side of the green, front left. This is 66 feet. Plays it away, gets it on the green, trying to get it to release, and that is going to come up well short. And that's in the 20-foot range, so both players will be scrambling to put a 3 on the card here. DJ at 15 under, Rahm at 14 as we get ready to make the turn in this second round.
Yeah, all long bunker shots are more difficult, but I think because the hole location was in the very back of the green with that thick Bermuda rough behind it, and if you were to catch that thin and run it over the green with your bunker shot, it's an impossible, almost impossible up and down. So he erred on the side of staying below the hole.
Let's move up ahead, Doug Bell.
Justin Thomas in the fairway left here at the par 4, 10th down in the valley, will now have an uphill second shot, 116 yards, covered by the shadows from this huge oak tree that is off to his left, the only shadow on this fairway. JT, club behind the ball. Uphill second shot on the way. That will land behind the hole, catches the ridge, and now slowly rolls back down that hill. Still trickling down the hill. Be about 12 feet. Let's go to Mark Carneville.
Roy McIlroy, well left of the fairway, behind some trees, and if he can get this somewhere up near the green, that'll be a great shot. Lands it about 40 yards short of the green. Ball chasing up there. Oh, this is going to be a really good shot. Just scoots past the hole on the left-hand side, and that is inside 6 feet. What a shot for McIlroy. Judged it perfectly. He'll have a chance for a birdie here at the 10th to get the 9-under.
Man, was that fun to watch. Through some trees, as Carney described, rolls some 50, 60 yards on the ground, and comes in just behind the hole. He has a great chance to turn bogey into birdie.
Yeah, and McIlroy really needs it. I mean, one over at the turn, so the back nine was where he got things going. And quickly yesterday, a 5-under finish, 3 in a row coming in, and probably needs the same thing again. He's minus 8. And Rory losing ground right now, 7 back, Bill.
All right, here's Dustin Johnson. This is his par putt here at number 9, the par 3 uphill. And 19 feet away, putting into the shadows. This is online, but it's going to stay left. He thought that might turn, but for the second day in a row, Dustin Johnson's going to bogey the par 3 ninth, circles around, taps this in. So he goes birdie at 6, bogey 7, birdie 8, bogey 9, 14 under, going to the back 9.
I have to admit, Bill, I thought that ball would turn to the right also, but you can't blame it on the putt. You know, miss the green and don't get the bunker shot close. Looked like bogey all the way.
Just inside, 45 feet now at 11. Former Tour champion Xander Schauffele, a putt to get 4 under on the round. 10 under for the week and make up a little ground as he is over it, putting through his shadow. Ball on the way, pretty good roll. Needs to move, though. It was online, comes up short. That's 3 feet or so short for Schauffele to clean that up to stay 9 under, Bill.
All right, John Rahm, he's just off on the collar of the green, but this is a downhill 12-footer, and this is for his par. Gives it a tap down the slope it goes, holds this line, looking pretty good. Oh, and that whist on the left. And another knee bend from the Spaniard. So he's going to give a shot back here. Should be able to knock that in for par, but he remains one shot back at minus 13.
Yeah, he thought he made it. It looked awfully good. Think about it. It's a par 3. He used his putter 3 times. and it's going to count as a one-putt bogey.
Back at 10 now, Doug Bell.
Justin Thomas changed his routine just a bit here at number 10. Looked at it from the side. Hasn't done that all day, and now from 12 feet, birdie try. Barely drew the putter back, trickling down the hill at the hole, and oh, that scorched the left edge. He went down to the ground in the catcher stance. Frustration continues with a flat stick for JT. Another par, and he stays at 11 under even for the day.
You're listening to exclusive coverage of the Tour Championship, the final event of the FedEx Cup playoffs, from historic East Lake Golf Club in Atlanta, Georgia. And as we do at the top and bottom of every hour in our live play-by-play coverage, time now for a leaderboard update presented by Titleist.
Once again, it's a leaderboard full of players trusting Titleist with 70% of the field, relying on the speed, precision, and consistency of the Pro V1 and Pro V1X. Titleist, the number one ball in golf. Dustin Johnson drops one, but 14 under, still good for the lead. Stumble for he and John Rahm at the turn. So they head to the back nine on Saturday. DJ still in front, 14 under. Rahm second, 13 under. Justin Thomas now three back, where he started the week, 11 under for the week for Justin Thomas. Even par today so far at minus nine. Sung J.M. and Xander Schauffele making up a little ground. And now we'll see if the reigning FedEx Cup champ can get there. Mark Carnevale.
At the 10th green, after watching Justin Thomas just miss his birdie putt to the left, gotta figure Roy McIlroy's gonna keep this ball just inside the right edge of the cup from 6 feet for birdie as that ball rolls down the slope, turns right to left and into the bottom. A heck of a birdie here at 10 for McIlroy. He's back to even on the day, 9 under the tournament with a birdie here at 10.
Patrick Reed, a Masters champion, a player who's made seven straight trips to the Tour Championship, is 4 under par for the day, and it's 4 under par on the back nine with one hole to play, the reachable par 5, 18th. He is 6 under par for the tournament, tied for ninth. Young rookie Scottie Scheffler, in his first visit to East Lake Golf Club for the Tour Championship, is 4 under par and finished a great 66. That makes him 5 under for the week, but tied for 12th. And former Players Champion, U.S. Open champion, Webb Simpson, and not having the week he's won it, he came in here in fourth place in the FedEx Cup standings, but shot even par yesterday and is plus one today through 12, minus five. He's also tied for 12th.
Path to the PGA Tour, the Korn Ferry Tour, finished now with round three in central Illinois at the Lincoln Land Championship presented by LRS. Charlie Saxon opened the week with a 61, still in front at 18 under par after third round 68 today. Anders Albertsen, solo second, 17 under and one back. Mark Carnevale.
After making birdie at the 10th, Rory McIlroy had to wait here on the tee at the par 3 11th as Xander Schauffele rolled in a three-footer to stay at 9 under. Now McIlroy, 219 yards here at 11 to a back left hole location. This green tilts from left to right as McIlroy makes contact. This is a high towering shot working towards the right side of the green. That ball lands middle right, takes a hop, and stays right there. That'll be outside 30 feet for McIlroy. He'll have that uphill birdie putt to try to get to 10 under here at the 11th.
Patrick Reed is 4 under par with one to play on the back nine. We'll see if one of the leaders can do something similar.
Be nice to hit some fairways for this group, Bill Brzezinski.
Boy, wouldn't it? John Rahm did a lot of that on his opening nine, didn't pay a lot of dividends. And he is in the left rough here, some 89 yards away on this short par 4. We'll update what happened to Dustin Johnson on this hole. He is still not on the green in 2. Got a front right hole location. This is way up into the air. And this lands on the front of the green. Well, release. This is a pretty shot by John Rahm. There you go. Rahm's had so many long birdie tries today. Lots of greens. Not a lot to show for it, but that's inside 10 feet. DJ, club slipped out of his hand on contact, and he still had only went about 240 yards, and he did not have a shot. He was in the right rough along the tree line, so it just played out, and that ball scooted across the fairway into the left rough. So he'll be hitting his third. So DJ survived that front nine. Remember that 31-footer at 4 to save a par? The chip in at 8 for the birdie when he was short in 2. Got to start straightening out the driver here. We'll see what he can do here. Third shot coming up from the left rough here at 10.
I agree with you, Bill. He's got to straighten out the driver. I wonder if the club actually did slip during the swing. You don't see that very often. I know it's warm here in Atlanta. Sometimes in the heat of summer when you're playing at Memphis or some of the places where it's hot, you may get that situation. But whatever the problem, he's got a lot of work left trying to save par here on his 10th hole.
Yeah, I mean, because that was right and short. I was wondering what happened there for Dustin Johnson. And, yeah, it's a rough way to start the back nine, but it's still DJ in front by one. For now, Mark Arnavell.
Yeah, you're certainly on the right side of the green here. When you're on the right side of the green at the par 311th, Rory McIlroy now 32 feet uphill. This ball will work right to left off the back edge of the green. That'll push the ball left as that ball gets up towards the cup and just slides by. So McIlroy, just a tap in for par. Par is always good here at 11, and he will do just that. As that ball just came up just a bit short. He makes a par here at 11. McIlroy remains at 9 under.
Let's go back to 10. Bill Rosinski.
39 yards. Dustin Johnson's third shot here at 10. Oh, this is a pretty play. This is going right at the flag and scoots by on the left from the left rough. Boy, that almost went in. A couple of feet left. A little downhill. We're going to have to be careful, but that will be for a 4 to keep him at 14 under. Nicely done.
Yeah, I think that's the big change he made some 6, 7, 8 years ago when he learned to play those softer shots. Quite often, guys who are really long off the tee are very steep. They're not as shallow with the wedge, harder to control the distance. He has figured that out. That was gorgeous.
Awesome job to, looks like, keep him at 14 under, Doug Bell.
Here at number 11, this tilted green, it slopes severely from back to front. And Justin Thomas in that right-hand corner and coming all the way up to the left-hand corner outside 30 feet for JT. Long birdie try on the way, climbing the hill. He's holding the pose and it just missed. Boy, I tell you what, I mean, he is absolutely snake bit with his putter. I mean, that took a peek as it went by. So another 2-putt par for Justin Thomas, and he stays at 11 under. And that, by the way, is 20 putts through 11 holes.
Back to Bill Rosinski at 10.
All right, 7.5 feet. John Rahm for birdie. This would tie him again for the lead. Makes contact. This ball goes to the cup, and that went left. In fact, I think he hasn't lost his turn. And the Spaniard a little hot. He's going to take his time here and put a mark on this. So about 3 feet away, missed opportunity for Rahm here at 10.
When you haven't had many opportunities for birdie, you mentioned that he made the one he had on the fifth hole for birdie, and now all of a sudden he's got another very makeable one. Sometimes you might try a bit hard, but wasn't able to convert there.
Just a golden opportunity for Rahm to pull even again and couldn't do it, so it looks like DJ's going to escape a really bad tee shot short and right with a possible likely par now to stay in front, just barely in front at 14 under par with Rahm knocking his in for the par save to start the back nine at 10. So just one birdie, one bogey, and looks like DJ's going to survive here at 10, Bill.
It's been that type of day for Dustin Johnson. So John Rahm did make his 3-footer for par. And now DJ, also about 3 feet away, but he's calling in his brother Austin, his caddy. He said, let's make sure we get this right. And this would be a good 4 after what happened off the tee. And then that great third shot to this point. And DJ has been up and down all day. 3 birdies, 2 bogeys as he made the turn, including the last 4 holes with 2 birdies, 2 bogeys. And now Dustin ready to go. 3-footer. Maybe a tad downhill. Putter blade slides behind the golf ball. White pants, light gray slacks, white cap, white shoes for DJ today. Gives it a tap, and that goes in. Good 4 for him. He stays 14 under.
Let's head to the 12th, Doug Bell.
On the 12th green, putting through a shadow from 11 feet. Left to right bender, Xander Schauffele with a stroke. Online at the hole, and it cut right in front of the cup. I mean, it definitely was halfway over the front edge and then would not go down. So just a par from 11 feet for Xander Schauffele. He stays at 9 under. That's 6 consecutive pars after the birdie at 6.
So Dustin Johnson, great up and down to make par, stay in front of 10. They will head to the par 3 at 11, the 2017 Tour champion. Xander Schauffele takes a closer look.
11, I play the hole based on the pin location. You know, front pin, that left bunker is dungeon. You know, you're going to have to make a 20-footer for par, no matter how good a bunker shot you hit. And besides that, I like to play from right to left, just having that bailout right and then maybe turn it over to the center of the green, but very much center green. You know, all the par 3s out here are longer than normal. And if you can take a 3 home, then you're plenty happy.
I would agree. If you can take a 3 home, you will be happy. It's playing 4 yards, 5 yards longer than the scorecard yardage, 219 yards with that back left hole location. You got to be careful not to go long. It's playing almost 2/10 of a stroke over par, so it's a very hard hole to make par on. There have only been a handful of birdies. Players are struggling a bit here. Actually, if you look at it, there's only been 2 birdies so far. It's a hole, like Xander said, if you can make par, you take it and run to the 12th tee.
Par threes are tough. This one is a perfect example. Down to you now, Bill Rosinski.
Yep, DJ is going to go first. 219.
You're at 11. Tee ball is away. Of course, there's a pond there, but with these pros, that shouldn't be a big factor. That's going to land in the middle of the green. Let's see if that kicks up there and releases. Okay, safe play. Long uphill birdie putt. John Rahm will play next. And, Mark, you're exactly right. One of the hole captain here is a good friend of mine. Used to live with him in the same area in Roswell, Georgia, and drove up to say hello again today. And he said, Bill, there's only been 2 birdies here. Ryan Palmer, the first group through, made one, and Mark Leishman made the other one. So we'll see if we have John Rahm ready to walk in here. Rahm made the turn even, and he was not happy missing that 7.5-footer for birdie here at 10. Rahm has chosen a 6-iron to this back left hole location. Once again, the 11th, playing 219 yards. Way up into the Atlanta sky, partly sunny here. And that just makes the front of the putting surface kind of slides off to the right. So John Rahm holding true to form here in the second round. Hitting greens, but 9 miles away for birdie.
That's the same thing we saw on the ninth hole, the uphill lengthy par 3. John Rahm comes up a club short. But I understand it as a player. You want to get back to the back hole location, but these greens, and this is one of the most severe sloping back to front, as is number 9, that if you go just 2 or 3 yards over the green, you are in difficult time making par. So you err on the side of being below the hole, but not quite that far. He's got a lot of work coming up to get this putt to the hole.
Let's go up one hole, Mark Carnevale.
Hey, you talk about a lot of work. Rory McIlroy missed the fairway left here at the uphill par 4, 12th. He's got 135 yards, but we saw him escape back at the 10th, but this is going to be one escape if he's able to pull this off. Has to keep it over an overhang canopy of a tree, under, I should say. Then he has to get over a bushy tree. Actually gets through there, lands short of the green on the left, kicks through the collection area towards the left greenside bunker and into the left greenside bunker. Not sure if that's where he was aiming at. It's going to be a challenging bunker shot, but a pretty good effort from where he was. McIlroy over the green in the bunker here at 12 at 9 under.
Boy, I tell you, these guys are struggling, it seems like, all of them. And the scores haven't gotten away from them. And we know some players are great, playing great, and this back 9 is definitely gettable.
Justin Thomas now next. Doug Bell.
From the first cut on the right side, 119 yards, going right at that hole location. And that ball winds up just left, maybe about 7 or 8 feet. So, again, knocking on the door for Justin Thomas. Now, it's not an easy putt, but we'll see if he can roll in a birdie. This would be a second birdie of the day.
Yeah, I mean, got to just be patient. It needs to make a putt, certainly get things started. But the distance, getting it inside of 10 feet, it gives you a good opportunity.
Final group, Dustin Johnson, the leader. John Rahm, one back. Have putts coming up at 11 in 60 seconds.
As a birdie look here at the 11th, he's one shot behind his playing partner, Dustin Johnson. This is the par 3. Another green in regulation for John Rahm, but other than a couple of holes today, he has had 20, 30, 50 footers for birdie. This is 57 feet. He's on the front right portion of the green, and the hole is back left, dead uphill. Maybe he can get something to fall and turn things around here like he did yesterday when he got on a roll starting at 12. Up the slope it goes, making its way to the cup. That's going to turn to the right. This still comes up a little bit short. So not in yet. He'll put a coin on this. So let's go up a hole. It's a Mark Carnival.
At the par 4 12th, Rory McIlroy has a lengthy bunker shot, 78 feet, but a difficult one. Playing all the way to the back right hole location. Has to land this, I think, just inside the fringe, some 10, 15 feet short of the hole, and then the ball should release to the right. Lands it there, ball chasing to the right, working towards the hole. This is an excellent shot. That is inside 3 feet for Rory McIlroy. What a play there. That'll be for par here at the 12th to stay at 9-under for Rory McIlroy.
Yeah, when you see the skills they have in every aspect of the game, there's a reason why these guys are, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 in the standings, and they're playing up to that, too.
Let's go to Doug Bell.
Here at 12, Justin Thomas knocking on the door again from 14 feet, putting through his shadow. This will bend hard from left to right. The strokes is on the line, making the turn and into the bottom. He walked it in. Justin Thomas, how do you like that? He's back to 12 under par.
That's what he needed, and maybe it did not come too late. With 7 holes ahead of him, he could make a real run. And because the leaders haven't gone low today, we're talking about Rahm and Dustin Johnson, he can possibly catch them before the day's over.
Yeah, DJ just outside 20 feet. Bill, back to you at 11.
Well, Dustin Johnson, 23 feet for birdie here at the par 3 11th. Again, uphill. Told by my friend, the hole captain here, all these putts end up about 3 feet short. DJ sends this up, and that was a pretty good roll. That did not end up short. It's hung over on the right side. And he's going to circle around here and tap this in. But this would be a good two-putt. It's a tough green. And this would keep DJ at 14 under par. And down it goes. So he'll be off to the 12th hole, still 14 under.
Let's go back ahead up to Mark Carnevale.
Earl, up here at the 12th green, Rory McIlroy rolled in his par putt from just outside 4 feet. So a great up and down for McIlroy. He stays at 9 under with a par at 12.
Yeah, that was an important save, too, at this stage of the tournament. Don't forget, he came into this week at a deficit to those guys at the top of the FedEx Cup standings. He was, I believe, at 12th on the standings, so he needed to make up some ground. Doesn't want to give any back this late in round two.
Let's go back to Bill Rosinski now.
Well, I think this is a huge putt for John Rahm. He's got 6 feet for par here at 11. It's been a grind today, just having good looks for birdies. Doesn't want to lose a shot to DJ here. Steadies the feet. Again, this is slightly uphill. And remain one back. Well, that's not going to drop. Slid off to the right. And the frustration continues. So he had a good birdie look at 10. Couldn't get it to fall. 3 putts from 57 feet. He's back to 12 under.
This is the time of the round for John Rahm. To keep his cool, we see a little frustration as he slams his putter grip to the ground. You could see the apprehension in that stroke didn't quite lock in and misses on the low side.
Way up ahead, Colin Morikawa gets a birdie, another one for him at 17. So he's got 5 on the card today, and he's minus 8. And is trying to make up some ground late in the day on Dustin Johnson. Still has most of the back 9 to play. And now for DJ, a 2-shot lead as we continue coverage from East Lake Golf Club in Atlanta. PGA Tour radio coverage from the Tour Championship. Atlanta, we always wrap up the FedEx Cup playoffs in Atlanta, Georgia. East Lake Golf Club in the city of Atlanta. The metro area ranks among the top 10 in the United States, a population of more than 6 million people, right behind Philadelphia at number 8, just ahead of number 10, Phoenix. And it's been an entertaining first couple of rounds so far at the Tour Championship with some of the biggest names in golf, as they have been doing throughout the restart to the PGA Tour throughout these FedEx Cup playoffs. They are battling again. Dustin Johnson has the lead, but Justin Thomas, John Rahm now lurking in a tie for second. Let's go to 18. Mark Carnevale.
Arrow, player that started number five on the list at 5 under, Colin Morikawa, shot one over yesterday, but has had 5 birdies and a bogey today. He is now 4 under for the day, 8 under for the tournament. And after a good tee shot here at the 18th, 248 to this front, or we'll call it a middle left hole location, as Morikawa makes contact. And this ball will land short of the green. It'll try to get to the front edge, won't get there. Some 6-7 yards off the front edge of the green, with that hole location again, middle left. Morikawa looking to either hole that or get up and down for birdie here at the 9th, or should say the 18th. Morikawa at 8 under par.
Yeah, no surprise to see young Morikawa make this kind of move, reigning PGA champion. He is a very mature young man, and all of those skills are coming into play here at East Lake as he tries to make this big move. This will be a big putt to get to double digits, 10 under par, and see how close he is at the end of the day.
From there, but DJ is going to have to make an up and down, a spectacular one to stay at 14 under.
Now let's move up one hole down, Doug Bell.
All right, Earl, Justin Thomas off the back edge of the green here at 13. Ball sitting down in that Bermuda rough, but normally pretty good with this kind of shot. We've seen it at least 4 times over the last day and a half. He's about 25 feet away, and he's now getting the signal from the guys at 17, and they're pointing back at him. You go. This is where a lot of greens and tees converge on this part of the course. Now JT right back at it, wedge behind the ball. Again, just outside 25 feet. Looking to chip this in for birdie. On the way comes, hops on the dance floor, rolling out towards the hole, and nestles down there quite nicely, about 2 feet. It'll be an up and down for Justin Thomas to stay at 12 under here at 13.
Yeah, he made a very difficult pitch, a chip, look very easy. Hit it like a bunker-style shot. But as you said, Doug, we've seen him do that 4 or 5 times this week, and he's done a great job with it every time.
Couldn't even see that ball. What a nice shot, finesse shot by Justin Thomas. Mark Carnevale.
Colin Morikawa from 35 feet off the green lands it on the fringe and caught that a little heavy, and that ball stopped some 10 feet, maybe a little further than that, underneath the hole. That ball is one of those situations, Mark, in these Zoysia fairways. The club catches in the grass and you're not able to release it. He will have a birdie attempt to try to post 9 under here at 18.
That's a good observation, Carney. That Zoysia and Bermuda, both similar, and they're very tough grasses. And if you just get a blade or two further behind than you want, it just stops the club. And it looks like, as you described it, that's what happened there.
Well, not exactly fairways and greens here for Dustin Johnson, the leader at number 12. And he's working hard again to stay in front, Bill Rosinski.
Yeah, and this will be his third shot, and he's deep in the rough, not far from the hole, just 19 feet, but he's only got about 8 or 9 feet worth of green to work with, so he's got to get it up in the air, maybe catch the collar, because it's downhill. As soon as he hits it, pops it in the air, does hit the collar, makes its way down to the cup, has a chance to go in, and hits the left edge, and then scoots on by. He quickly watches that ball as it releases to some 5 feet away. Well, he almost holed out again for a birdie, and he's got a little comebacker here trying to stay 14 under.
Yeah, another one of those key putts you look back on at the end of the day and see, did it keep the momentum going? But he just put it in a tough spot. Could have done a whole lot better if his gravity just ran that ball outside at 6 or 7 feet.
And right now, DJ with a two-shot cushion to work with on a Saturday, Doug Bell.
On the 13th green, Rory McIlroy looking to make a push on the back nine again at East Lake. He's 21 feet away, this to get to 10 under par. Has to come up and over a little ridge. The putt sends it on that way, making the turn to the hole, but not enough. It came off that hill and never came back to the left. So inches outside right, Rory will walk up and tap that in for the par. And he stays at 9 under even for the day.
And now back to another long putt for John Rahm, Bill.
Well, this is where it all started yesterday on the back nine. He threw in a 20-some footer. This is 28 feet uphill. We'll turn to his left. Ball is moving inside 10. Needs to turn left. Good looking line. Stretch. And he just didn't hit it hard enough. Still talking to himself. I don't know if I want to hear that conversation either. He's going to walk up. That's another par for John Rahm. So still 12 under.
Yeah, we've had over half the hole locations in the very back of the greens. And in these traditional style golf courses, the greens normally all slope from back to front. And it's hard to hit it hard enough to get it all the way back to the hole. Understand why these guys are coming up short.
Easiest hole at the back nine to finish again at that par 5 at 18, Carney.
At the par 5 18th, Colin Morikawa trying to finish off this round with back-to-back birdies. The one here at 18 from 10 feet below the hole is putting into the green, and this for a round of 65. The PGA champion makes contact with the ball, working up the slope towards the cup and in. Nice finish for Colin Morikawa. Birdie at 17, and the birdie here at 18 shoots a 5-under par 65. He'll head into Sunday at 9-under par.
Yeah, he's going to head into that third round Sunday, as you said, Carney, 9-under. But I think more importantly, with that birdie finish, 65 with a lot of momentum.
Match is the best round of the day so far. Morikawa in now, Bill.
All right, here's DJ for par at 12. Left edge putt. Up to the cup. Ooh, it hit the left edge, spun right. Well, he finally paid the price again. He's been able to scramble and make some good up and downs. That's going to be a bogey for Dustin Johnson, and he is now 13 under par.
Yeah, disappointing. Got to blame it on the drive. I mean, he's putting himself in a tough spot, you know, hole after hole. Got to find some fairways, DJ.
Only two, and it did cost him there. Missed fairway, missed green, a bogey. So the lead is down to one again for Dustin Johnson at 13 under par as we continue PGA Tour radio coverage. For the quest for the PGA Tour's ultimate prize, the FedEx Cup at stake this week at the Tour Championship.
Championship going hand in hand, and if you're going to travel here by air, you'll land at Hartsfield-Jackson International Airport. Since 1998, it's been the world's busiest airport. Last year, it served over 111 million travelers, with a passenger terminal stretching more than 45 football fields in length. Obviously, traveling on the slowdown side now because of the virus, but the airline's trying to bounce back, and so too is Dustin Johnson here in the second round. He has struggled hitting fairways, just coming off a bogey at 12, so his lead now down to one. He's 13 under par. His tee shot here at 13 in the right fairway bunker. John Rahm, okay, maybe in the first cut, but down the left edge of the fairway. Rahm's just got to get closer to the hole. He has been hitting green, fairways and greens, but not getting close for birdies. So right now, DJ's struggling off the tee, but still 13 under.
You know, that's a good point, Bill. You mentioned it yesterday. Even though he only hit three fairways, he averaged 26 feet proximity to the hole on his approach shots. Well, he's hit a few more fairways today, but how about this? Averaging outside of 45 feet a hole. The game can be strange sometimes, but you do have to get it closer than that to have makeable birdie putts.
Yeah, and for Dustin Johnson, you know, the day started. He hit a great tee shot at one, no problem. It was an easy tee shot, striped it at the first hole, missed a couple, then hit the fairway at five. So, you know, he hit two of his first four, but hasn't hit one since. So he's missed, what, five in a row now, six in a row for Dustin Johnson, six fairways now missed for him after starting two for four, and you just can't keep going along like that. I mean, it's amazing. I mentioned it a couple of minutes ago when he had opened up a two-shot lead. I don't know how he's done it. I had hitting only two fairways, and now it finally cost him really big time at that 12th hole, and it's a matter of time before it catches up, Mark, and it certainly has now, it seems, midway through the round to DJ, whose lead is in trouble now.
And he's the one that made the proclamation, I need to hit more fairways. I got to find fairways. Hasn't been able to do it. And these fairways, the very fact that the course is a little bit softer because of the rains late last week, early in the week, it's not like they're rock hard fairways. There's not a lot of camber on these fairways like you might have in different courses. They just have not driven the ball that well.
Let's go to Doug Bell up ahead.
All right, Earl, Rory McIlroy in the right-hand rough here at 14. This 521-yard par 4 has 200 yards to go, and was ready to go, and now goes back to the bag and change club. Looks like he's perhaps going back to less club. You know, went by that line. It's kind of sitting up. So perhaps he thinks he's going to get a flyer out of that right-hand rough. And the hole is front right. And this is a big green. I mean, you could wind up some 50, 55 feet away if you go all the way to the back of this green. Rory in the shadows right. Sunshine blanketing the fairway. Let's see if he can get it close. Tough shot. He whacks that out of that rough. It lands short of the green, then rolls up on the putting surface. This is an excellent shot from Rory McIlroy. Just past hole high left, about 16 feet. Chance to go 10 under. Let's go back a hole to Bill.
Well, Dustin Johnson avoided the fairway bunkers on the right, but did not have a good stance or lie. So he was able to get a club on the ball and get it on the green. Now we got a back left hole location, so I'm just going to be happy just to get it there. But he's still going to be outside 25 feet for birdie. DJ on the green in regulation.
It's still a very good recovery right there.
Now, and the flip side is John Rahm has done a better job hitting fairways today. Three yesterday, six, and another one hit here today. But now he's fallen out of a share of the lead, Bill.
Yeah, just got to get it closer. I mean, he made some really good putts yesterday outside 20, 25 feet up to 29. But today, I mean, he's had 40, 50-footers. Let's see if he can get it close here from 116 yards away. And that's not great. That just lands in the middle of the green, spins back. I think he's further away than DJ is right now. So really struggling here to get it close to the flag. Let's go ahead to Doug.
Justin Thomas hit a nice drive down the left side, this rolling fairway, about 190 yards remaining. JT's been solid today. He's not happy with this shot, though. That'll miss the green over on the right side, but only by 4 or 5 yards. But again, that's the short side, so that'll be a difficult up and down. Not a lot of green to work with, and it slopes away from him on that angle, too. So we'll see if JT can pull out some magic to stay at 12 under.
It's going to take magic from above that hole in the rough, shooting down. Green goes away from him. Grain on the green goes away from him. It's not the spot you want to miss it where JT hit it there.
And we'll find out if he can get up and down in 60 seconds.
Play where the pros play and book your next golf vacation with the PGA Tour's TPC Network. Take advantage of incredible spring vacation offers at some of our most iconic courses, including TPC Sawgrass, TPC Louisiana, and TPC Scottsdale. Live the PGA Tour experience and walk the same fairways as the game's greatest players. Stay and play vacation packages are available now. Visit tpc.com/XM to learn more. Welcome to golf at the highest level. Welcome to TPC.
Introducing Titleist Tour Speed, where speed meets performance. The new multi-layer technology delivers the ball speed, distance, and short game control you need to play better. Faster than Callaway Chrome Soft, Bridgestone's Tour VRX, and TaylorMade Tour Response. Get new Titleist Tour Speed, or get left behind.
We started today with Dustin Johnson and John Rahm in a share of the lead at 13 under par. And we mentioned the fact that on a Saturday, only round two, there was a chance that those two could have separated themselves from the field. That has not happened so far, and things are actually tightening up, Doug Bell.
Yeah, long way to go. On a golf course, it's only going to get tougher as the week goes on. Justin Thomas, 23 feet away, but off the right of the green, has a wedge in his hand. And not a lot of green to play with. He has practiced this shot at least a dozen times now. Wide stance, blade wide open. Giving it one last look. Here's a little mini flop shot up on the green. Hops past the hole on the right side with a lot of sizzle. And it finally comes to rest about 6 or 7 feet past the cup. Not bad from where he was. Has to hit a putt to stay at 12 under.
Yeah, not bad at all from where he was. He's done so well on those tough little shots out of the rough, even the ones downhill like that one, and he did it again.
And Dustin Johnson and John Rahm kind of, you know, frustrated with the way things are going today, and that final group there combined one over right now in this second round, Bill.
13th green, John Rahm has lined up a 39-foot birdie putt. This is going to be
uphill most of the way and then kind of flatten out the last 7-8 feet from the middle of the green in the back left hole location. Ball's on its way. It's going to slide to the right. Needs to turn back to the left. Well, I'll tell you what, the pace was really good. That ball did swing right at the end, and he will tap that in. That'll be a par. He'll stay 12 under.
Back now to Doug Bell.
Here at 14, Rory McIlroy has 20 feet. For birdie, a putt that's going to move from his left to right. He's coming off a little slope there. That's where the ball's nestled. Just to get to 10 under par. Putter behind the ball, the stroke. Sends it out to the left, swinging back to the right. It's on track, and oh, man, it kissed the left side of the cup. And Rory looks skyward, thought he had it. Inches past, he will wind up with another par. Let's go back a hole to Bill.
All right, Dustin Johnson for birdie. Uphill, 32 feet, and Austin, his caddy, pointed to a spot a good 3 feet left to aim for. He's going to turn to the right, turn some more, and that was just too far out to the left. Again, good speed. Ran by about 2.5 feet. He'll put a coin on this, but should be able to stay 13 under.
Yeah, he should be able to make that one, but I know one thing he's going to want to do. He's going to want to hit some fairways, especially on this next hole, the most difficult hole on the golf course year after year. On 14, so that's what he's got to do to make the correction coming in.
Well, and now the top four in the leaderboard to start the day. Justin Thomas is the only one of those four players right now under par for the day, Doug Bell.
Here at 14, needing this to salvage a par from 6 feet, Justin Thomas sends it on the path at the hole, and that missed right all the way. That started turning right on contact, and Justin Thomas about 3 feet past the hole. And so he'll put down the mark, reposition that line on the golf ball, and walk around and try to regroup. He wasn't happy with that stroke, and now just wants to drop just one. You know, this all started with a perfect drive over the left side, well down the fairway, misses the green right, pitches it past the hole, misses it from 6 feet, and now 3.5 feet for bogey. Walking back in. I think this is a big putt at this stage of the game. You don't want to drop one here. You don't want to get sloppy. Putter behind the ball. JT sends it on the hole. At the hole, and it goes in. So just one drop shot, and he's back to 11 under, and he's shaking his head walking off the green.
Well, Earl, I don't know if you put the announcer's curse on him saying he was the only one of the three under par, but he's back to even now. None of the top three on the leaderboard are under par.
No, you kind of proved my point, because the point was that all those players, those big names atop the leaderboard, have not played well. They have not been sharp today, and they've opened the door for guys like Sung J.M., who hit one to 8 feet at 15, the par three a moment ago, and knocked it in for another birdie. So Sung J.M. at four under. And at minus 10, he is now just three off the lead at the Tour Championship. And him is solo fourth with DJ even par, McIlroy even par, Justin Thomas even par, and John Rahm plus one. The top four players in the world have combined one over today in the second round, and it's opened the door for things to tighten.
Yeah, and that birdie you described from Sung J.M. is on that par three, the 15th, with water all around. Yesterday, it was only 150 yards, no big deal. Today, 226 yards. That was a heck of a birdie that Sung J.M. made on 15 to get the 10 under par.
2 for 10. Those are the numbers for DJ off the tee. It's been an adventure, Bill.
Well, we'll see what he does here at 14, the tough par four. This hole playing 521 yards. John Rahm already teed off. He hit a beauty. This is going a little bit left. And in the rough. So we'll see what kind of lie he has there. Mark McCumber, this hole reminds me a lot of Sedgefield Country Club, the 18th. Now, this has a little dog leg to it. That's where they play the Wyndham Championship. But it's a long, over 500-yard par four. You don't see where the ball lands off the tee. You usually have a downhill shot to an uphill green. We just saw that golf course a couple of weeks ago. This is a monster hole.
Yeah, I agree with you. The tee shot's quite similar to Sedgefield's 18, but the second shot is downhill instead of the uphill shot you have there. The good news is that you may not have been able to see that yet, Bill, but Dustin Johnson's ball is sitting up. We can see the entire top half of the ball in the rough, so that's going to give him a chance to get to this right hole location.
Well, I'll tell you, he's got a good chance now making up ground because of the leaders for the struggle of the leaders all day. Colin Morikawa, PGA champion, shot 65 today. First appearance at East Lake in the Tour Championship. He's in at 9 under par and making up a little ground today. He spoke a moment ago to Mark Carnevale.
Well, Colin, nicely played today, particularly that finish with birdies at 17 and 18. What was the difference between today and yesterday?
Just staying a little more focused. You know, I kind of let some bad shots yesterday on 17 kind of just lead into 18, and I hit a great drive yesterday on 18 and couldn't convert. So it's about just playing my golf. You know, I'm a pretty patient person, and yesterday I just got a little out of hand.
Talked a little bit earlier in the week about the fact you haven't really seen this golf course much. You've played it a few times now. What's the key for you that you believe to play this course well?
Oh, you got to hit fairways. You know, playing out of the rough, unless you're the luckiest golfer out there, you know, you're going to have some pretty bad lies, and the pins are only going to keep getting tougher, so angles are going to be a little more important. But if you're playing out of the fairway, you can go at some of these pins with the greens being fairly receptive.
At 9 under par right now, you're currently in a tie for fourth. Yeah, those guys got a little bit of a lead, but it's really about how many players are between you and the lead, isn't it?
A little bit. You know, hopefully by today, you know, I'll be within a handful or six shots. We'll see how the guys finish up. But, you know, there's two more days. And I really like how I was playing today. And I just got to keep that up, kind of play well the next 2 days.
Well, good playing. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, two things I take out of that interview from Carney with Morikawa is that he realized yesterday he lost a bit of patience, so had to get be more patient today. And what else was the theme, Earl? What's the theme we could say in unison? Hit more fairways. Guys got to hit fairways. Everybody's saying that.
Well, and Colin Morikawa mentioned the stumble coming in and the struggle yesterday. He had to play well today. He was 5 back to start the week at 5 under par, shot 71, lost a bunch of ground yesterday, so he kind of made up for it at 65. Right now it puts him 4 shots off the lead. We'll see where that is by the end of the day. But it was a much-needed rally for him in round two. And on to Sunday, and we'll see if these, you know, guys atop the leaderboard, namely Dustin Johnson, John Rahm, and that final group, if they continue to struggle here in the back nine with DJ's lead now 13 under by one.
Yeah, if you go to the top four guys coming into this round, the last two pairings, even throwing Rory McIlroy in there, we've talked so much about Thomas, Rahm, and Johnson, none of them are under par. They've done exactly what all the chasers need. None of them have run and hit. And you and I both thought that someone in that group would shoot 3-4 under and distance themselves. We haven't seen it.
Well, you had Dustin Johnson, John Rahm starting the day 13 under, Justin Thomas minus 11, Rory McIlroy minus 9. The four top players in the world rankings, you figured one was going to go out and shoot a decent score. Still an opportunity to do that, but like you mentioned, combined, those four are one over today, Bill.
All right, Dustin Johnson in the left rough here at 14. Not a bad lie. 166 to a front right hole location. Pitching wedge, the choice. Guess gets it on the front of the green. Oh, that's a nice looking golf shot from where he was. That's getting closer. That's about 10 feet away. Hole high left. Well done by DJ. He'll have a nice birdie try here.
There's a great example of where long hitters, even when they drive it in the rough, have an advantage. Don't forget this hole is 521 yards long, a par four, driver wedge. When you can take a wedge out of thick rough and kill it by going high in the air, Bill, you're going to have a chance to get it close, and that's exactly what Dustin did.
John Rahm now in the middle of the fairway, another fairway for John. He's got 156. The problem's been the second shot. He's been hitting greens. Just can't get it close. Ready to go. A slightly downhill lie. Elevated green. Holds that follow through. A little bit of a breeze. Helping the golfer. That's going to land a hole high left. That's probably 5 feet further away than DJ is. So both will have birdie tries here at 14.
Yeah, birdie tries they do have. If they could make one here, it's like picking up a stroke and a half on the field. And don't forget, you want to have some good vibes as you head off this green, because the 15th, the par 3, is really a tough hole today.
We're going to move up one hole to Doug Bell.
Here at 15 is Xander Schauffele after an excellent tee shot. 13 feet above the hole, putter behind the ball, left hand low. Birdie try on the way, rolling at the hole, and that's rattling at the bottom for Xander Schauffele. A birdie on a tough par 3, and he is back to 9 under par. Well done.
Boy, that's an understatement, Doug. I mean, that's playing, it's tied with number 8. It's the hardest hole in the golf course. There's never been a bad 2. I don't care how short or long the hole is, but that's a really special one there.
Playing well. Let's see if he can keep it going. Coming in, coming off birdie at 15. Sung J.M. from 183. Good drive at the 16th as he's aiming at that back hole location. Hits 20 feet away, and this is trickling up closer. Inside 10, inside 5. That's 3 feet away for Sung J.M. to go to 11 under par.
I am so impressed with this young man. He just dominated Korn Ferry a couple of years ago. Has already went on the PGA Tour, had a great rookie season. And here he is right now contending to win the Tour Championship. It's an impressive run we're seeing out of this young man.
I mean, he plays basically every week, and he's always playing well. Mark Carnevale.
Harold, how about a difference here today at the 15th? 150 yesterday, now 226 into a breeze as McIlroy makes contact. This up in the air, this needs to go a little bit. This drifting to the right. Oh, that lands on the bank short of the green. It hangs there in the rough, but boy, the wind gobbled that one up. Rory looking down at the ground and a little bit of a dismay. May have been a slight mishit, but very fortunate that ball didn't find the penalty area.
Yeah, he was very fortunate. We can see the ball sitting up, Carney. He got a lot of green to work with. But I really think when you hit a cut and the wind comes up into your face, it's not going to penetrate like a draw. And we're getting a look right now at Rory and his caddy are smiling, like happy that they're not in the penalty area.
They escaped. Stay dry, Doug Bell.
Well, Justin Thomas will be next, coming off that bogey at 14. He's 11 under par. Again, the teeing ground today is all the way back on the other side of the lake. Yesterday, they played from a chute up on the hill about 100, maybe 150 yards to the left of where they are today. And I would say today's teeing ground is much more difficult. The hole 226 yards away, and Justin Thomas takes dead aim. Not many players better than Justin Thomas with an iron in his hand on the PGA Tour. There's that pre-shot waggle he's done ever since he was a little kid. His dad taught him that. Looks at the club, puts it behind the ball, and the swing. It's an aggressive line. This is moving from right to left. That's going to land right in front of the hole and then roll past the hole on the left side. Oh, that's going to be a great shot, about 10, maybe 12 feet for Justin Thomas, looking for bounce back birdie.
That was really aggressive. That's a man who trusts his swing. This tee was changed from last year. Took out about a few trees, made the tees bigger, and you can see the difference.
Yeah, those tees, that's basically a full carry over water. Bill?
Well, here at the 14th green, John Rahm, 19 feet for birdie. Front to right hole location on this Saturday. This is round number 2. So putting across this green from left to right. Really need something good to happen here. Ball's moving. Has a chance to drop. Stretch. Nah, missed right. Hey, looking at the line, he thought he had made that. Just kind of slipped off to the right at the end. Another par for John Rahm. He's still minus 12.
Yeah, still. That'll be a good par on that hole. And as he moves to the tough 15th in just a few moments.
You're listening to exclusive coverage of the Tour Championship, the final event of the FedEx Cup playoffs, from historic East Lake Golf Club in Atlanta, Georgia. And as we do at the top and bottom of every hour in our live play-by-play coverage, time now for a leaderboard update presented by Titleist.
Once again, it's a leaderboard full of players trusting Titleist, with 70% of the field relying on the speed, precision, and consistency of the Pro V1 and Pro V1X. Titleist for the number one ball in golf. And now on the back nine, Dustin Johnson with a one-shot lead on John Rahm. They were tied to start the day. DJ, even par, has pulled in front. Bill Brzezinski.
Yes, 12-footer here at 14. Maybe a little left to right break to it. Sends this up to the cup. Lips out, almost a 360. Austin, his brother, the caddy, took the hat off, almost slammed it to the ground. He could not believe that didn't go. He'll tap in for par. DJ still 13 under.
That caught a lot of the cup. Horseshoe around, no go for DJ. But even par, 13 under, still with a one-shot lead. John Rahm, one over par today, slipping to minus 12. Sung J.M. just knocked in the short one at 16. He's got one of the better rounds of the day going, 5 under with 2 to play. Sung J.M. is pulled within 2 of the lead, tied for 3rd with Justin Thomas at minus 11. And then 9 under par, Rory McIlroy, Xander Schauffele still on the course, and Colin Morikawa in at minus nine. He shot 65 today.
Yeah, two-time winner already this season. Brendan Todd came in here with a great record this year. He's one under par through 16 holes, seven under par for the tournament. He is in a tie for ninth and past U.S. Open champion, past tour, excuse me, players champion, Webb Simpson, not having the start to the tournament he wanted. He is plus one for the day and minus five for the tournament, tied for 12.
Corn Ferry Tour in Springfield, Illinois. This weekend, path of the PGA Tour at Panther Creek Country Club, the Lincoln Land Championship, presented by LRS. They are through three rounds. Charlie Saxon in the lead at 18 under par, one up, and Anders Albertsen, who's second at minus 17. Doug Bell,